Hello friends, welcome to our Dress My Craft YouTube channel. My name is Isha Tripathi and today I'm here to tell you about flower pearls from Dress My Craft. But before that, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with all the latest new releases and free tutorials. Dress My Craft offers 6 different colors in flower pearls. They come in transparent jar in packing of 30 grams each, and these jars are absolutely reusable. So let me just show it to you how these flower pearls look alike. These flower pearls are mix of different size of pearls, or you can say combination of different size. Some are micro pearls and some are little bigger than the micro ones, and they look absolutely beautiful on your projects. So I hope here you can differentiate the size I'm talking about. These flower pearls can be used in creating flower centers and can also be used in creating mixed media backgrounds, which actually makes these flower pearls quite versatile. So here is the beautiful purple color, and here you have the pink color, and the very beautiful and my personal favorite green color. These flower pearls come in pack of 6 and can also be purchased individually. I will be telling you few ways of using these flower pearls. So let's just get started with that. We will be creating flower centers using the flower pearls. I have taken the pointed flower die from Dress My Craft and I am spritzing some water on my flower die cut to soften it out. Now I have been using the broken china distress ink to color my flower petals. I'm simply rubbing the ink pad on my craft mat and spritzing some water to activate the ink. Now I'm slightly drying the flowers using my heat gun. Once the petals are dry, I have taken the Dress My Craft embossing pad and medium ball tool to shape the flower die cut. I'm shaping each petal individually here. To add extra color, I am using the faded jeans distress ink to distress the edges of my flower petals. I am just simply distressing the edges here, as you can see it on screen, because I was thinking broken china was a little light in color. Now once I've achieved the desired color, I'm going to shape the petals again using my ball tool. To adhere these petals, I am using the Ultimate Craft Glue from Dress My Craft. This glue is super tacky and thick, and with the help of my ball tool, I am applying some glue to paste these petals on top of another, keeping it in an off-center position. And lastly, I am applying some glue in the center to paste my flower pearls. I am going to use the pink flower pearls to put it in center. And you can use any color whichever you like. It is absolutely your creation and your choice of colors. So here you can see I'm simply putting some glue in the center and I'm just pouring these flower pearls on the top. Now I'm going to repeat the process of creating flower but in different color, just to give you the feel that how these different flower pearls look. But I would like to show it to you a different way of creating flower center. I have taken a 12mm styrofoam bud. I am directly dipping it in the Ultimate Craft glue jar, and now I am dipping this bud along with the glue on it in my white flower pearl jar. So here you can see how beautiful these styrofoam buds look with the flower pearls on it. I have used these buds to make the flower spray. Now coming back to the flower again, I am shaping the petals with my ball tool and adhering these petals with Ultimate Craft glue in an off-center position. I am happy with its shape coming, and I shall be applying some more craft glue in the center with my ball tool and shall be filling it with the white pearls. Isn't this super cute? I am in love with this flower pearls and how my flowers are coming out. If you find this video interesting, do hit the like button. It really helps us in creating more fun videos for all of you. Now I've taken this drop shape pollen in white color, and I'm simply dipping this pollen head in Ultimate Craft glue. Now I've taken this micro mini pearl beads and I will be dipping this wire pollen in that to make the flower center. This just looks absolutely pretty. You can make tiny little flowers with this pollen. I'm taking this small flower die cut and spritzing it with some water to soften the paper out, and I'm coloring this with mustard seed distress ink. Now I shall be shaping this flower petal using the Martha Stewart flower shaping tool. And now after heat setting the flower, I will be poking a hole in the center with my golf tool and putting some craft glue in the center and placing the wire pollen in the center to finish the look of my flower. This just looks absolutely super cute and pretty in person. The flower pearls can also be used in creating mixed media backgrounds. Just to give you the feel of it, I am creating a tag here using my Dress My Craft rounded tag punch, and the size I'm using is of 2.5 inches. I have taken the Crafter Workshop stencil and I'm applying some plaster paste by Prima Marketing Art Basics and heat setting the paste. You can also allow it to dry naturally, it is absolutely up to you. To color the tag, I am using the green apple impasto paints and I am coloring the tag randomly. You don't have to be perfect for this process, you can just go and paint the tag. And I am using my heat gun to quickly dry it out. You can also allow this tag to dry naturally. To decorate the tag, I'm using the Natural Seashells Set 2 by Dress My Craft and I'm pasting them with the help of my Ultimate Craft Glue. This craft glue is actually super thick and tacky and does have a very strong adhesion, and you actually need to apply it with the help of a brush. I'm applying some extra craft glue in the gaps between the shells and will be filling it out with the flower pearls. You can mix these pearls in any mixed media gel and apply it with the help of spatula on the background of your project, or you can even apply it on stencils to create a textured background. Now I will be filling this with the flower pearls in green color. But you can use any other color of your choice, whichever you like, it is absolutely your choice. So here is the final tag. I have used some Prima Gold Wax to tone down the vibrant green color and decorated with handmade paper flower using the pointed flower die set by Dress My Craft. Here is the another super grungy textured mixed media background I have created using the flower pearls purple color. On the right hand side of the window you can see the close up how grungy this textured effect is coming up. So here is the final look of the styrofoam buds which we created earlier. I have used the pointed flower dies from Dress My Craft to create these flowers. You can use any color flower pearls to create these styrofoam buds and they just look absolutely beautiful. Here is the another way which we did to create our flower centers. I hope I was able to inspire you all to create your own beautiful flowers and mixed media backgrounds using the flower pearls from Dress My Craft. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with all the latest new releases and free tutorials from Dress My Craft. Till then, take care, bye, and happy crafting.